Let's give Wiz and Debbie Stroud a big round of applause.
Coming out now, we've got Rex MacArthur from Broadway, North Carolina, driving Finn and Fur, two great Percherons. They're pulling a two-row John Deere corn planter at circa 1936. This outfit is owned by John Hudson Farms in Newton Grove, North Carolina. Coming out next is Ronald Hudson from Asheboro, North Carolina, driving Polly, a little mule owned by Bernie Harbitz. The first mule to pull a wagon across Newfoundland, pulling a 1960s buckboard. Next we have Chris Hunt from Pembroke, North Carolina, driving Samson, a big black Percheron, pulling a McCormick number 9 sickle bore used to cut grass and hay. Jose from the North Carolina State Fairgrounds, if you're in the building, please report to the show office. Jose, please report to the show office. Next we have Roger Manning from Williamston, North Carolina, driving Bill and Bob. Two gray Percherons pulling a 1930s Bemis transplanter used for setting out tobacco. Following up will be Kenneth Edwards from Kinley, North Carolina, driving Sam and Jerry, two big black Percherons. They're pulling a one-row McCormick Deering cultivator used in the 20s, 30s, and 40s. These horses are owned by Spot Rouses. Next we've got Ray Hatcher from Council, North Carolina, driving Jake and Joe, two John mules. They're pulling a 1938 New Idea transplanter used to set out tobacco. This outfit is owned by John Hudson Farms in Newton Grove. All right, we've got Dan Lancaster from Pikeville, North Carolina, driving Gus and Sarah, Little Ann and Eight Dutch. There are many mules, and this is the daddy of the other three. Pulling a Hackney wagon that is over 100 years old, is considered a horse and a half a wagon, and that's Henry Lancaster riding shotgun. Next we have Bradley Glover from Pikeville, North Carolina, driving Minnie and Pearl, two black Percherons, pulling an International High Gear number 9 sycamore used for cutting hay back in the day. Then bringing up the rear, we've got Donald Stroud from Seven Springs, North Carolina, driving Jed and Judd, two Suffolk Crosses. They're pulling an early 1900s Hackney wagon. And the shotgun rider is Hal Till. This is just a picture of back in the day of all the farm equipment that was used in the early part of the 20th century. Let's give all the teams a big round of applause, please.
underneath the crowd a little while ago.
Believe it or not, I used to come up with these hay with number 9 McCormick.
Let's give them one more big round of applause and say thank you to the arena.
This is the life of the world back in the park in the morning session.
Come on, get up, get up.
Farmers would challenge each other to see whose horse or team could pull the most weight. Since then, horse pulling has evolved into an organized form with teams of equine athletes. Many of the teams shown are working regularly to keep their muscles and tendons strong and limber to prevent them from being hurt during the competitions. The related sport of tractor pulling developed as farmers moved away from the use of real horsepower. Our bid is
and we have a full pull of 3,000 pounds.
off the wall.
Thank you for promoting the Mule class here. Folks, did you like the Mule Pole tonight? Yeah! I am here still, but I'm not from Columbia, Kentucky. I'm from Whitesville, Kentucky. I came 650 miles. I'm 18 miles this side of the Indiana border. But you have a wonderful facility here, a great crowd, and folks, I'd like to see this Mule Pole go forward. Would you? You like it?
Thank you so much for coming. We appreciate it. If you bring your winning team,
013453. Again, your winners.
Cobra got three hands and a calendar we want to give away, so there are enough numbers to do that.
And your winners are again on the Mule Pool were Duke and Bud from Burton and Greer out of Columbia, Kentucky. It's Bob, photo op. Another winner is 013574. That's again, while we're going through some of the formalities and getting some photo ops here, just want to ask, recognize some of our vendors, the Mule City Specialty Feed. Valentine's is coming up. Go by and see Larry Wade at Jackson's Western Store for all your saddle and leather needs. See Pauline Brown at their 50-50 tickets. They'll be giving away those prizes shortly. Also, don't forget the This Breed excels in Western, hunt seat, saddle seat, jumping, dressage, driving, and fox hunting. Please visit the vendor table for more information on this wonderful breed. Again, that's the Friesian breed, and this is Bob Coffey and Reagan. These are wonderful examples of the Friesian breed here. Give them a big hand. Give them a big hand as we send them out the gate. Team number 8 is Jake and Rock. Again, owner Ira Green out of Lenore. Again, if you don't wear your number, we can't announce who you are or where you're from.
This last thing is number 16.
I'm never sure.
You're good. You're good. You're good.
You take the picture.
Yeah, we're not grabbing camera. We're naming this territory.
Where's that?
That's why we're up here.
Where's that?
For 50-50 round. So we'll put right in the middle of the ball. So what's the problem?
And a full pool from Jensen Rock on a right of the easy full pull there for Rex and Zoe. Next team.
Billy, go through and see if we can help you guys.
Take care. Oh, really? Okay. I'll go through it. I haven't thought about it, but I'll go through it and see if there's
any. Yeah.
Most of it's the old.
And a full pull for Ricky Bobby.
Alabama.
First out of the hole, we start Charlie and Dan Jordan out of Taylorsville, North Carolina. And a full pool for the lightweight team.
They're not cooperating. The horses are not cooperating.
This one's turned around. I mean, told a friend of mine, I said, can I come and jump to me? They can jump to me. He jumped 4 foot without even looking. And he hated it because he kept the foot.
And a full pool there for Bruce Rex out of Newport, Pennsylvania. And a full pool for Duke.
But they said, this Friday night, probably going back to TV. You know, we on me TV, I had another TV, one of the two.
And a full pool there for Jesse and Rock. Tom Bowman with Mike and Bud coming up next. John Bowman with Rex and Toby on deck.
I'll tell you where you can find a bunch of them.
And a full pool there with Mike and Bud out of Martinsville, Pennsylvania. And a full pull there with 5 out. full pull there, Bodell, with Rock and Bob. And a full pull there for Chip and Mike out of Amherst, Virginia.
That's where he focuses.
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's real nice.
So you can just sit here and it does it for you. They're not even working yet.
And a full pull by Ricky Bobby.
And I know I'm focused.
Quiet, please.
It is. I didn't realize it did that when I blocked the thing. It's like this camera has gotten 10 times better than I expected it to be since
I started. Isn't that nice that happens?
It is. Quiet, please.
open bull there again. 6,000 pounds there, Bully. Coming up next will be Hudson and Green with Jake and Rock. And a full pull there for Jake and Rock out of Lenore, North Carolina. Tom Coleman with Mike and Todd coming up next. Odell Kohler with Rock and Bob, team number 10 on deck. And a full pull there for Tom Coleman out of Orangeville, Pennsylvania. Coming up next, Odell Kohler out of Sloan 50-50 girls. We got somebody down here at the end of the arena that wants to buy some tickets if you're still selling. And a full pull by Bill Healy out of Mount Airy, North Carolina. Coming up next will be Ricky Bobby in Alabama, driven by Chad Miano out of Nicholsville, Virginia. Bobby in Alabama, let's give them all a big hand. Full pulls all across the board at 6,000 pounds. And a full pull there by Odell Coley out of Statesville, North Carolina. Chuck Dunwell coming up next with Bruce and Rex, Guy Jones. Inches on the first pull. He's passing his second pull.
quiet, please. And a full pull by Tom Bowen with Mike and Bud. John Bowen with Rex and Toby on deck, coming up next, and on deck will be Hudson. Driven by John Bowen out of Mechanicsville, Maryland. And a full pull by Jake and Ron. Tom Bowen coming up next with Mike Todd, with Odell Coley on deck with team number 10. As we add more weight to the sled, it becomes more and more important to be extremely quiet. And a full pull by Mike and Todd. Coming up next will be the heavyweight team of Rock and Bomb by Odell Coley, followed by the number 11 team of Roy Cash. Chip and Mike coming up next, followed by Joe Jones. Max.
compete. Chad Miano coming up next with Ricky Bobby in Alabama. Blaine Chapin coming in to the sled now. Chad Miano on deck. Inches on the third attempt. Passing on. Oh, that was real close, 26 feet 5 inches out of 27 feet 6 inches. Real close, and it's getting more and more important to be quiet when these horses approach the sled. So please, please bear with us and cooperate with us. Let's get these teams as... Coming to the scale sled now will be Todd Bummer with Mike and Todd.
Coming up with,
and we got a full pull there with Hudson and Green.
honor with Bob and Rick's. And a full pull there from Philip Burton with Bud and J.R. And third time's charm there, full pull by Bill and Lee. Chet Miano coming up. Six inches on his third and final pull there at 8,000 pounds for Dan Jordan. Again, get into short rows, so we'd like your patience here. Followed by Odell Coley. the green team with Bob and Rex.
And a full pull by Philip Burton with Bud and JR. Fine job there by Zach.
Thank you. lower. Whoa!
Second place, Bill Healy out of Mount Airy, North Carolina, with Mike and